Hello and welcome back to today's video. In today's video, we are going to learn about how to create this particular drawing called handle inside Siemens NX. Okay. Now this will be the third video in which we are actually creating a file or a model from a 2D model itself or a 2D drawing itself into 3D so that we can get a clear perspective about how and where exactly how you can make this particular set of models. Now in this particular handle, the most difficult part to make or to model is this particular area, the handled area. Bottom part is fairly simple. It is created with a simple extrude itself. Now here we are going to use the swept command in order to create the shape, because here we can see section A, B and C and dimension for section A, B and C as well. Okay, so let's get started. Now first of all, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start a new file inside NX. So here I'm starting a new part file inside NX. Now what I'm going to do next is I'm going to create a sketch, let's say on the front or on the right plane. So here I'm selecting to create a sketch on the front plane, that is my XZ plane particularly. Now here I'm going to create a arc, first of all, starting from the origin. It's a 3-point arc, starting from the origin, finishing somewhere over here, and an arc is like this, somewhat like this. Now what I'm going to do next is I'm going to make the center point of the arc and the end point of the arc horizontally in the same line. So these two are horizontally aligned. Now I'm going to define the radius of this arc. So the radius of this arc is going to be 60. Now here I'm going to define the radius of this particular arc as 60. Now once I'm defined with the radius and also located the center point properly, the next thing what I'm going to do is I'm going to create this line which will be tangential to the arc. So what I'm creating right now is the guide. Okay, so this is the guide which I'm making right now. So this particular line is at an angle of 15 degree and it is having a length of 200 mm from the center of this arc. Okay, so here I'm creating the guide. For example, I'm creating a line like this. Then I'm going for rapid dimensioning, defining a distance over here of 200. Okay, and the angle from the x-axis as 15 degrees. Now once I define the angle and the length as well, so here my guide construction is ready and my sketch is already fully constrained. Now what I'm going to do next is I'm going to click on finish to finish my sketch, and now I have to think about making the remaining part. Now before I start constructing the sections, okay, I have to have a close look on the section itself. Now as we can clearly understand, this particular section has total of 8 segments, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 lines, 1, 2, 3, 4 arcs. Okay. Now this particular segment on the other side has total of 6 segments, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, out of which 3 are lines, 1 is arc, and 1, 2 in the bottom. Okay. And over here, similarly, we have only 4 segments. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. So I would prefer to make only 4 segments for each one of them. So I'll ignore fillet for now. And I'll, without the fillet itself, I'll create my entire design. So the first sketch what I'm going to create is section A, and that will be located at the very end of this particular curve, and that will have a size of 70 by 70. So let us start modeling that. So here I'm creating a sketch on the top plane. Here I'm creating a center rectangle from the origin. So let's say here I'm choosing rectangle command, activating center rectangle, and here I'm creating a center rectangle from the origin. I'm making both the sides equal to each other and defining a length of 70. So here I have created a simple rectangle of 70 by 70. Next thing what I'm going to do is I'm going to create section B without the fillets over there. Okay. And now I have to understand where exactly section B will be located. So section B will be like a center rectangle of 50 by 50. And after which we need to create an arc of radius 30. And the center of the rectangle is what is going to attach with the guide. So let us start making that. So here I'm going to click on sketch. I'm going to choose on path. And here I'm going to select the path. Now I don't have to select the entire path. Okay. So what I can do is I can choose single curve and select only this particular part of the path. And then I can click OK. Now because we are not oriented in the correct way, we have to think like we are oriented in a perfect direction and make the sketch accordingly. For example, here I'm making the sides equal, making them both of 50, and then creating an arc from this point to this point likewise. Now once I have created the arc, then what I have to do here is I have to define a radius of 30. So here I'm going to create a radius dimension of 30 and then convert this line to reference. So here I've converted this line to reference as well. Now I'll click on finish and this particular section is also ready. Now before we begin with the last section, let us first understand how exactly this section is going to get modeled. Now here we have a radius of 20 and a side length of 20. So technically this bottom is going to be of 40. This side is going to be of 20 by 20. Now let us start modeling this, and this is going to be at the very end, and the center of this particular circle is what is going to get attached with the guide. So here I'm going to click on sketch again, this time on a path again, single curve. I have to model this on this very end. I'll click OK. Now I'm inverted, so I have to model invertedly. Okay, there are ways in which you can actually change the way it looks and also change the way it is oriented. But for now, we'll go for a while, like because we only need to create few sketches. We are not going to go in that detail. Now here, I'm going to make this and this line tangent as well. And I'm going to get rid of this extra part. Okay, now the diameter of this particular part is going to be 40 because the radius is 20. Okay, now I'll click on finish and this is how I have completed my third sketch. Now technically all my sketches are ready and all my sketches have equal number of segments inside each one of them. I'll go to the surface tab and choose the option called swept. Now here in the swept command, first I'm going to reset the command itself so that we are all on the same page. Now here in the section tab, I'm going to choose connected curve and I'm selecting my rectangle from the bottom left corner. Now I'm clicking on the add button here and then selecting my second object again from a similar relative point. Then again I'm clicking on add button here and again selecting third one from the same location. Now here in guide, I'm going to select tangent curve and I'm going to select this as my guide. Now here in interpolation, I'll keep it linear for now and activate preserve shape. And this is how the linear interpolation is going to look like. Now, I want it to be smooth, so I choose to use cubic interpolation, but cubic doesn't even look that great. So what I'm going to do rather is I'm going to use the interpolation called blend. The blend interpolation, as we have discussed in the video where we were learning sweep, is only available for three sections. Not less than 3, not more than 3. So here we are going to use a blend interpolation. And once this particular part is ready, this is how exactly it's going to look like. Now, obviously, this doesn't have the fillet which is required of radius 6 on all four edges. So let us start defining that. So here I'm going to click on edge blend. First, I'm going to set the radius to 6. I'm going to select this edge, this one, and this one. And going to define all the four edges with a radius of 6. And all are selected with a curve rule of tangent curve. So this way we can clearly see how this particular part has been defined. And as we can clearly see over here, I'll just hide all my sketches so that we can have a clear understanding. As you can see, this particular part is becoming narrow as it goes in the front. And let's see the diagram. This is what is happening. And even the bulge over here is very similar. Next thing what I'm going to do is I'm going to create this particular part of 100 by 100 with the radius of 10 and with a total height of 25. Okay. Now I have already created a rectangle in the first part of 70 by 70. So what I can technically do is I can select the same sketch. I can click on extrude. Now here I can just change the direction in which I'm creating an extrude. I want to go down. I want to go with a value of 25. Okay. But I don't want a rectangle of 70 by 70. I want a rectangle of 100 by 100. In that case, I have to choose an offset of 15. Now you can wait here and comment why I have chosen a value of 15. Here in Boolean, it will be united. I'll click OK. This is how the entire thing is going to look like. Now, once this particular part is done, then simply I can hide my sketch and start defining the fillets. So here the fillet is going to be of radius 10 and of radius 8 and of radius 4. So first I'm going to define a fillet of radius 10 to all four corners. If you are using a current version of NX, it will be even faster. So here I'm defining a radius of 10. Then here on the top, I need to define a radius of 8. And I'm going to click on the add button here. And here I'm going to define a radius of 4. So once I'm defined with all the radius, this is how the entire model is going to look like. So I hope you got the point. I hope you understood how exactly we can build this model from ground up, from understanding the 2D drawing up until the point we create a 3D model. So thank you very much for watching. Have a great day ahead.